Good morning, everyone, and welcome to our 2019 Teacher and Educational Service Professionals Recognition Program. Congratulations to each and every one of you here this afternoon. At this time, I would like you to meet the CC Tech Honor Guard and please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance and presentation of colors.
Concert band, and under the direction of Mrs. John.
Bridgeton High School School Choir. So as they get seated, we welcome all of you.
The Bridgeton High School Choir is pleased to present two selections for you this morning. The first one is called Count the Stars, which is actually a requiem or a funeral prayer, blessing those that have passed on, followed by Running Home to You. And if you're a fan of the TV show Flash, it is from the musical edition of Flash.
I will count the stars for you. Thank you.
Mr. Brenner and Mrs. Johns, before you go, I'd like to invite Dr. Thomasina Jones, Superintendent of Richmond Public Schools, to present you with a small token of thanks on behalf of both associations and everyone here today.
Good afternoon, everyone. Mr. Brenner and Mrs. Johns, if you will come forward at this time. And let's give our students another round of applause. As a proud parent, we just want to say that on behalf of the Cumberland County Association of School Administrators, we support you in the work that you do, especially in the arts. So we want you to know that we appreciate your untiring and unwavering support of our students. And this is a small token of our appreciation. Thank you so much for all that you do for our students. Thank you.
Thank you. Bishop of Arundel, I proclaim that we honor your ways until our young Queen Elsa comes to age.
May they rest in peace. Bizarre. Nothing like the life I once saw. For the
between the sons of King. Very small kingdom. Please accept my humblest apologies.
Of course, great towns of the Southern Isles.
Thank you, Autumn of Arendelle.
Okay, can I just say something crazy?
I love crazy.
Thank you.
I'm the very fortunate director of these kids. Actually, so what you actually hear here is actually only 2/3 of our group. We were missing 1/3 because we're on the 7th grade trip today. So, but this is an audition-only group, and they participate all over the world. Actually, we were actually asked to be the first group that did do the premiere performance of Frozen Junior internationally as well as nationally. So, so when people say that arts education only really happens in North Jersey and Central Jersey, they obviously haven't come down to Cumberland County. So, but we are very fortunate to perform all over our tri-state area as well as nationally. We want to thank Dr. Koza, who's our superintendent, our wonderful, amazing teachers from Seabrook, Moore, and Woodruff Schools, represented by our Teachers of the Year. So we want to thank you all for everything. Let's see, we've been asked to actually premiere a show that's coming from the West End in London this summer. Actually, I just got that like last week. So we're trying to figure out if we can do that this summer and put together a group for the summer. But this group performs in Atlanta, Georgia, and actually, and I have to plug this because this is South Jersey Education, the fact that our group, which is just like all of us in here, a regular public school, we were able to take on and beat two of the premier performing arts middle schools in the United States and beat them in ensemble work. So that's a testament to our teachers in South Jersey, our students in South Jersey, and we've been invited to perform in California, Australia, London. We were working on those things. So, but thank you so much. Thank you for all you do. Thank you for everybody that's here, our freeholders, our administration, and our teachers. Thank you so much for everything.
Thank you, Dr. Elliott. Our kids just keep getting better and better each year. So I'm just so proud of them. And Mr. Lau said he comes up with the ideas, and we're very fortunate to have Mr. Lau. And of course, I say yes, because these young men and ladies do a great job, and each year we continue to expand. So who knows, if maybe crazy enough, we may need to go on Australia. See Mr. Whale and Dr. Gleick literally go, we're going to be another year for this. We'll figure it out, because the kids deserve everything they can do, and again, you saw their work on display, but on behalf of our association, Mr. Lau, we want to give you a little token of our appreciation for the work you do up for Deerfield. Thank you very much.
I think they deserve another round of applause. Uninterrupted lunch. So with that, tables 10, 11, and 9 can go up and help yourselves. Sit back and relax. Oh, either end.
Real team has had the initiative. Ministry of Education for the last 7 years. It's been one of our main priorities to promote that here in Cumberland County. And you have done that for years. We now have your back and continue to have your back. We understand what education does for a community and individual. It decreases poverty, increases the ability to have a job, increases unemployment. We now have an unemployment rate now of 5%, down from 14% in 2012. We know that increased earning potential. We know that it helps help the well-being of a person and a family. And more importantly, it helps people with higher education, the ability to learn, their family units stay together. The job you do every single day sometimes goes unnoticed. But I can tell you right now, the Freedom Student does recognize that. And I'm going to remind you one thing that a mentor taught me years ago. When you enter that classroom every single day, no matter how difficult those students might be that day, remember there's one that's hanging on every word that you said. Focus on that one person, because it will make a difference. Thank you again to our Freedom team for what you do every day. Listen, there's some time, so enjoy.
At this time, I'd like to invite Dr. Thomasina Jones, Superintendent of Richland Public Schools.
Good afternoon, everyone. I would like to congratulate each of the honorees today for being the recipients of the Governor's Teacher of the Year Award. That is really something that's quite impressive and commendable. So congratulations to each one of you. And also, I would like to acknowledge those people who are being given the Governor's Educational Services Professional Award today as well. So congratulations to each one of you. I'm certain that your colleagues, your family and friends are extremely proud of each one of you. So at this time, I am going to acknowledge the staff from the Richland Public Schools District. This is an awesome team. My team knows that my mantra is, I would like to see the day when we do for every child what we do for our own, and that's by Jonathan Cazole. And that's what they have demonstrated today. So at this time, I'm going to call first to receive his award, Mr. David Ellen from Richland High School, Health and PE teacher, has been servicing our students and families for 28 years. Congratulations. Ms. Maury McLeod from Broad Street School, math teacher servicing our students and their families for 7 years. You're welcome, thank you. Mr. Devin Land, health and PE teacher from Washington Road School, has been servicing our students and their families for 11 years. Ms. Danielle Workman, Cherry Street School, grade 4 teacher, 18 years of service. Ms. Stephanie Saul is not here today. Ms. Carla Burlingame, Excel Program Technology Teacher, 6 years of service. Ms. Rebecca Franklin is not here. Ms. Caroline Cornelius, Cordova Lane School Teacher, grade 4, 12 years of service. And Ms. Amanda McCloskey, West Avenue School math teacher, 5 years of service. Let's give all of our Governor's Teacher of the Year. Congratulations to each one of you. So very proud of each one of you and the work that you do. Governor Educational Services Professional of the Year staff. Ms. Christina Akers, Richland High School, Instructional Aide, 10 years of service. 14. Oh, they have 10 on here. Okay, 14 years, that's right. That's your credit. You earned it, I see you at all the football games. Ms. Joyce Smith, Broad Street School, Technology Coordinator, 17 years of service. Congratulations. Ms. Cherie Logan, Buckshire Road School Instructional Aide, 7 years of service. Ms. Erica Caban, Surrey Street School Special Ed Instructional Aid, 5 years of service. Mr. Nathan Reed, Indian Avenue School Technology Coordinator, 10 years of service. Congratulations. Mr. Nathan Thomas, Port of All Names School Technology Coordinator. Mr. Samuel Friedman, Dr. Geraldine Foster Early Childhood Center School Psychologist, 3 years of service. Congratulations to the Bridgeton School District family.
I
Education Center's Teacher of the Year, 13 years in the profession, 3 years with us, so he's been growing as we've been growing with our student base, Mr. Timothy Campbell. I'd now like to ask Mr. Ralph Aiello, principal of Cumberland Regional High School, to join us in honoring our teachers from Cumberland Regional. Mr. Aiello.
Thank you. And congratulations to everyone on your honor. These two individuals, in my opinion, it's long overdue. For our Educational Service Specialists of the Year, to them, one of our aides for 4 years now in a self-contained classroom and really is just this, basically a co-teacher in that class, Mrs. Josette Carter. And our Teacher of the Year, who actually came in with me when we got to Cumberland Regional, when we came in together, is Mr. Tom Cook.
Congratulations
and thank you.
his honorees. Mr. Turner?
Good afternoon. I would like to introduce two dynamic individuals that work at Fairfield Township School. Our first young lady, she is an awesome young lady. She goes above and beyond. She's our teacher of the year at Fairfield. She's part of the Alpha Delta Kappa teaching sorority. I did talk to her sister to get some fun facts about her to introduce today. She said, please tell the people that she is a very dedicated teacher. There's one time where she slipped on some ice coming to school to come into the building. She broke her ankle, and instead of going home, they wheeled her in on a wheelchair to come to school to teach her kids. So I want to introduce and present to others none other than the dedicated Ms. Jacqueline Conahay. Educational service person. This young lady has been, Ms. Connie has been with the district 8 years. This next young lady has been with the district for 10 years. However, she's been over 30 years in nursing. She's one of the most kindest people that you could meet. She's a very generous person, very kind person. I mean, you could not have a better nurse in your building. We are gonna miss her. All the people come to her, we know her as the Surgeon General of Fairfield Township. And she always is available to give the teachers ice and crackers. So with that said, we want to introduce Ms. Diane Griffiths.
I have the privilege today to introduce to you two wonderful teachers. One teacher, unfortunately, will be retiring at the end of this year. She is our second grade teacher. She is a head teacher, and she has been in education for 45 years. Ms. Dodie Moncrief. We have a language arts teacher from our middle school who always inspires the students to really dive deeper into text and really to become great creative writers. She has been in education for 15 years. That's Mrs. Bridget Vanderveer.
Hi, everybody. Thanks. It's awesome to be here with all of these great professionals in the building. You guys are a perfect example of what education should be, so congratulations. I'm here to introduce our Teacher of the Year. It's Mrs. Nancy Cantino. She's been with the district for 18 years, teaching 6th, 7th, and 8th grade middle school language arts and social studies. Not science, social studies. Nancy is one of our best staff members. I get excited when kids get rostered to her class because I want to be in her class. She does a spectacular job. She makes language arts fun for kids. She really brings the curriculum to life. And she leads with integrity and common sense, which is kind of lost some days in this profession. So congratulations, Nancy.
Keep things moving along. I want to say congratulations to all of you. Thank you to Ocean First, Dr. Gletka. Thank you very much for helping us with this. Mr. Whalen, thank you as well. And our association, Johnson, thank you so much for making this all happen. I want you to realize this is not just, you're not just the best player of 2019. You didn't hit the most home runs. You didn't hit the game-winning shot. This is a lifetime of accomplishment just wrapped into one ceremony to say thank you. You are committed to our children, you're committed to our schools, and you're committed to our communities. And I truly thank you for that contribution that you made with your life. Because we know you certainly didn't do it for the money. I want to say that the two ladies I'm about to introduce you to are magnificent. Our Ed Services Professional of the Year. It is our response to interventions. And 5 years ago, we adopted a response to intervention philosophy, and we had never had one. So we needed someone who understood data-driven decision-making, someone that understood targeted instruction, and someone that really could hit the whole school culture to buy into that style of learning. And so Ms. Clemenson was selected to that role, and she's knocked it out of the ballpark, and it's really transformed our whole process of how we educate students in our building. So congratulations, Ms. Clemenson. Ironically enough, every time I'm at Disney World, I run into her. Next I want to introduce our Teacher of the Year is our middle school math teacher, our eighth grade advisor, and pretty much the person I go to anytime I need advice, anytime. It started out when she was in union leadership, I'd always go to her for advice. She's no longer in union leadership, but I still go to her recently, yesterday, when I need advice about our big pressing issues. Ms. Gozin does walk on water, she does, well, she changed water to wine, I guess we wouldn't be here. she does so much for our school. At graduation every year, every student is given two Kegel pins. So that they can give to typically someone that's inspired them greatly over the course of their time at our school. Typically they go to mom and dad, maybe grandpa or brother or something like that. Over her career, she's received 22 pins from different students, which is really commendable. And that's just all students. When we have some challenging students, she's like, I want them in my homeroom. And I'm like, they're already there. Please help me congratulate Ms. Colleen Good.
And apparently if I take too long, somebody jumps in the spot.
Seated at these two tables really exemplify that for Noble. So I couldn't be prouder of them, and thank you for all that you do. I'd like to start with Teachers of the Year. First up, Carol Ann Sisio, Teacher of the Year from Lakeside Middle School, teaching sixth grade special education, 24 years of experience, 24 years in Millville. Okay, now we're gonna follow the rules and clap at the end, okay? Our second one, Mr. Tom DeCue couldn't be here today, but I would like to just acknowledge Mr. Tom DeCue, teaching history and social studies, 25 years in education, 15 years in Boko. Next, Anne-Marie Economy from Silver Run Elementary School. She teaches resource room and class support for grade 2, has been in education 25 years, lucky to have 18 of those years being in Boko. Next, we have Amy Fabianovich. I had to practice that name. Mount Pleasant School, presently teaching second grade, 23 years in education, 17 years in Milwaukee.
Got it right. Literally spelled
it. Teacher told me how to do that one. All right, number 5, Megan Finch Williams. Teacher of the Year for the Child Family Center, our preschool, teaching pre-K, has been in education for 20 years, all 20 in Millville. Next, Graham Gann, Teacher of the Year, Memorial High School, presently teaching German, levels 1 through 5, or levels of German 1 through 5, grades 9 through 12, education 12 years, 12 years in Millville. Does a great job. He's got us back traveling to Germany, our students traveling to Germany. Really does an excellent job with that. Next, we have Sandra Geary, Teacher of the Year for Holly Heights Elementary Middle School, or Elementary School, teaching kindergarten. 23 years in education, 22 years in Millville. Proud to say that we started around the same time. I got to teach in her presence, and excellent, excellent job. Barbara Lohr, teacher at Bacon School, my alma mater, presently teaching kindergarten, 26 years in the district, 26 years in Millville. And last but not least for our teachers, Sandra Sivieri, Teacher of the Year, Rick Avenue, presently teaching Spanish K-5 World Language, education 21 years, all 21 years in Millville. Please give them a round of applause. Moving on to Millville's Educational Service Professionals of the Year. First up, we have Christine Armington, Silver Run School, presently a paraprofessional for math and bilingual support, education 6 years, all 6 years in Millville. You guys gotta clap. Oh, it was better when you clap. All right. I'm skipping and going out of order. I'm saving that one for last. The next one I'd like to bring up is Miss Patty Banker, Aiken School, presently paraprofessional in kindergarten, 20 years in education, 11 in Millville. Also does a great job, a great family. Next person is Margot Cerami, Rick Avenue, paraprofessional, kindergarten, 20 years in education, 20 years in Millville. Cynthia Fithian, Holly Heights Elementary School, paraprofessional, kindergarten, 21 years in education, 21 years in Millville. Michelle Garrett, senior high school guidance counselor, 18 years in education, 17 years in Millville. I need some guidance counseling after the session's over because it's awkward sometimes after I need it. But I need some help. Yeah. Number 7, Natalie Pierce, right? Child Family Center, pre-K 3-year-olds. 18 years in education, 18 years in Millville. Number 8 on my list, Mary Carmen Toledo, Lakeside Middle School. Paraprofessional math and bilingual support, 6 years in education, 6 years in Millville. And she is not here. Where'd she go? All right, last but not least, I'd like to ask a very special person to come up. Ms. Mary Bacon, Memorial High School guidance counselor, says presently, always been a guidance counselor as far as I can tell. 46 years in education, 40 years in Millville. And she was my guidance counselor, so. And you really feel bad for her, because you know, this is me all growing up and better, so you can only imagine what it was like. Trust me, they all freaked out when I came back as superintendent. Education is the passport to the future, for tomorrow belongs to those who prepare for today, and these educators are the ones that are doing a great job making sure that our kids have everything they need, and what they don't have, they provide it sometimes out of their own pockets. So please, big round of applause for the folks in there.
Every year, I had a special person that's been able to sit in the room.
learned and grew in classrooms in Vineland were honored here. And this year, for the first time, I get to give a hug to my daughter's teacher. And I have to say, she's had some phenomenal teachers through Vineland Public Schools, and this year is no different. So this is Bernhardt on behalf of Olivia Elliott and me. Congratulations.
I'd like to just take a minute to thank everybody who was involved in today's program. I know these things take a lot of work, and I want to thank all of you who took the time to be a part of it, so thank you. And I'd like to congratulate all of you here today for being recognized. I've been in education for 44 years, and every time we have a new teacher orientation, the one thing I tell our teachers and our paraprofessionals are that you are the most important people in our district. It is not the superintendent. It are the people that are in the classrooms with our children every day, our counselors, our teachers, our aides. You are the people that make or break our children, whether they are in preschool or in high school. You truly make the difference in their lives. And sometimes we don't know the difference we made for maybe 20 years down the road, but it's not only what you say, but how you say it. And some of these children go home, as you all know, to situations that none of us want our children going home to. So I need to thank you from the bottom of my heart for the job you do each and every day to care for our children. Thank you so very much. And now it's my pleasure, I'm very proud to introduce our Vineland Teachers of the Year. There are a couple who are not here, including the first one, who is a teacher at Varsity Elementary School. He has been teaching for 21 years, but he was unable to be here today, Peter Moniatis. Next we have from Palo Elementary School, Denise Lachette. She has been teaching for 16 years. From Delago, we have Stephanie Haynes. She is a preschool teacher and has been teaching for 9 years. I'm sorry, these are out of order. I had my list and didn't measure this. I apologize. Special to me, it is my daughter, and I'm very proud to introduce her. She's been teaching fifth grade for 10 years at Durant School, Lauren Cuello. She brought her little two-week-old with us, otherwise she wouldn't have been able to be here, so thank you for your patience. From Johnston Elementary School, Ivy Love, math teacher, 18 years. From our Pilla School, Renee Carfagno, social studies, 19 years. From Denny's Elementary School, Lucienne Prado, second grade King Clare research teacher, 23 and a half years. It looks like you won't even teach him for about two. From Pathway School, Victoria Kaffenberger, she's been a teacher for 16 years. From Rossi School, Megan Bernhardt, fifth grade teacher for 13 years. This is the teacher that Dr. Rossi just spoke about. From Sabatier Elementary School, Dana Martino, she is a first grade teacher and she's been teaching for 20 years. From Vineland High School, Donna Garrett, math teacher for 11 years. From Veterans Memorial Middle School, Emily Diaz-Chard, science teacher, 13 years. From Wallace Middle School, Catherine Checkley, physical education teacher, 14 years. And from Winslow Elementary School, Carol M., art teacher for 15 years. And now it gives me great pleasure to introduce our educational service professionals. From Varsity School, Alan Lutz, paraprofessional with autistic children for 26 years. From DePaulo School, Carnina Lepresti, a nurse for 11 years. From the Lago Preschool, Diane Brezen, nurse for 18 years. From Duran Elementary School, Anita English, an instructional assistant for the past 10 years. From Phyllis School, Ryan Sufi, he's the one that messed up the program. He came to our championship game, but Ryan came back. Thank you, Ryan. He has been our guidance counselor for 4 years and 14 years in our district. Thank you, Ryan. From many schools, Danielle Burns, basic skills teacher for 24 years. From Petway School, Rhonda Nonemacher, instructional assistant for 4 years. I don't think Rhonda's here. From Rossi School, Jane Bassetti, instructional assistant for 21 years. From Sabatier School, Rosita Harris, instructional assistant for 18 years. From Lyman High School, Kathleen McCabe, a social worker for 19 years. From Veterans Memorial School, Lauren Figueroa, paraprofessional for 9 years. From Wallace School, April Ward, paraprofessional instructor for 23 years. And from Winslow School, Josephine Rodriguez, an instructional assistant for 20 years. I'm so proud to work with each of you. God bless you all. Congratulations.
But anyway, we're here. I want to thank everybody again, especially Dr.
Loretta and today's event to make this such a great event, because all you out here today deserves recognition because of what you do for the students. And as Freeman said earlier, it's education that makes the difference for our children. And I've been coming here for 11 years, and Morello's been up here saying the same speech as the CR poverty level over there. Dr. Decker with the dissertation showing how the poverty level is decreasing in Cumberland County. It's a testament to what you guys are doing every day, and those who previously earned this recognition as well. So we continue to do this work, because our children deserve the best, and you guys work through the best. With that being said, our teachers here at Upper Deerfield, we're going to honor today. Every year I give a little poem, and this year was written by Marty Rotella, and it speaks to "Can You Love Every Kid?" And or describe all types of kids, and our three teachers that we're going to recognize here at Upper Deerfield truly love every kid. They've taken many kids who some would say they don't belong or whatever, but they nurtured them, they brought them through, and it shows every day when the buses come up at Deerfield, they're lined up. We have a kindergarten teacher, and when you see the older kids, recognize her, and say, "Hey, Mrs. Brown," and Mrs. Kraft is a fifth grade teacher, the students that she had, recognize her, and Mrs. Young, when students, she's in our middle school, so the kids who were sixth and seventh grade, but also the kids who come back from high school didn't recognize her. It shows the work they do, and that's what we want to see, you know? As you said, you don't see the work you do sometimes immediately, but every day when you see those smiles on their faces, you see them recognize that. So I just wanted to say that about our three teachers, because it's a testament to their work, and I appreciate what they do every day in our district. And so without further ado, our first recipient of the Teacher Award in Upper Deerfield is Ms. Megan Brown, kindergarten teacher, who's been with us for 6 years. Years, special education teacher, which